They may be the future, but council support for youth services looks set to be consigned to the past. Yesterday, a group of local residents seeking to protect services for the city's young held a protest outside Brighton Town Hall while councillors inside convened for the final full council meeting of the year.
We are working with some really, really needy young people, and our organisation is expected to have 100% cut in its funding from the local authority due to this budget proposal. So we are expecting to have to make redundancies, we're expecting to have to close youth groups, various projects.
The cuts to council services totaled an eye-watering £135 million and come as part of a broader package of council cuts that will affect not only youth, but victims of domestic and sexual abuse, among others. The Labour-led council have said that their hand has been forced by the National Conservative government, who have slashed funding to local authorities and social care, leaving a massive council deficit.
And we are desperately scrabbling around to try and find some resources to be able to continue youth work and youth services in the city. And some youth work will continue. So we've got Christmas to mull over it, we've got January, and then in February we'll come together and try and work something out. As I said, it's not going to be a return to what was there before. We just don't have the money. We're desperately trying to find some resources to continue some services and activities.
Campaigners argue that while youth services cost the council money in the short term, they're actually a long-term saving, helping those who could otherwise go on to use more expensive services in the future.
I think to the council, I would just say that actually this, what is ultimately quite a small amount of money saved, that is being proposed to be cut at the moment, actually saves so much money down the line in terms of the extra support and extra services that young people are going to need to access later.
Although nothing has been decided yet, the young people of Brighton and Hove are waiting to find out exactly where and how hard the cuts will fall. Michael Goodier reporting for Latest TV News.